I want to thank everyone. Thank you for coming. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you, everyone. Thank you for prayer line. Thank you for coming. God bless you. God bless you. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isigi. Welcome you in the name of Jesus. I'm from Overcomers Deliverance and Healing Ministry, based on Brampton, Ontario, Canada. You are most welcome. If you are around here, you can always come and visit us. Thank you very much once again. I'm going to talk the subject called, thank you, Jesus, hallelujah. The subject called the prayer to remove the garment of slavery and the backwardness. The prayer to remove the garment of slavery and the backwardness. There is garments that the enemy puts to people, and people, they are not aware the garment they are wearing. You look good, you wear, you put your perfume, you wear nice, you make your makeup, but in the world of the spirit, in the spirit realm, you look slavery. You have been wearing a slavery garment. You are going backward. Instead of going forward, you are going backward. That is the garment of slavery and backwardness. This morning, God is going to remove that garment that has been in your life that cannot make you to do profit. All the work you are doing is only slavery. You cannot do any work that will profit, will produce any good. You do the job like a slave. When you are a teacher and you are working in the factory, that is slavery. That is backwardness. That's working backwardness. If you are a doctor and you are not doing the right job that you went to school, that is slavery. That is backwardness. You need to go and do the right thing that you are supposed to do. You are supposed to have own your own supermarket, your own store. Now you are working under somebody. And that is backwardness. People have business, PA, they have degrees, but you find they are doing contrary from their career. That is slavery and backwardness. Now we are going to look in the book of Joshua, the book of Zechariah, whereby the high priest Joshua was clothed with the filthy garment. The garment of shame, the garment of slavery, the garment of backwardness. Now, when God looked at Joshua, he saw Joshua filled with the garment garment of shame, garment of slavery, garment of backwardness. You may be walking under the spiritual realm, you are naked. You are wearing legs. Your garment, you are dirty. Because enemy has made this. The witchcraft, they programmed very well that you cannot achieve anything. Instead of going forward, you are going backward. Years and years, you've never done anything that you can show people. I know some people, they work very hard. They have two jobs, even three. A person was saying that, I had someone in the prayer line that he's doing three jobs, not sleeping. She can't sleep. Even her children, they don't know her. The children are alone by themselves. And this woman is single. So now you see something like that. That is working. That is slavery and backwardness. May God help us. God Almighty may deliver us. He will remove this satanic garment that people are wearing, that they cannot achieve anything. In the book of Zechariah 3, verse 3, the Bible says, now Joshua was clothed with the filthy garments and standing before the angel. You can be filthy garment standing in the church, but you have filthy garment. The enemy has filled you with the filthy garment. Filthy garment. Satanic garment. You go to worship in the front of God, raising up, but in the spiritual realm, you are naked. Yes, Lord, thank you, Jesus. We thank God that God is able to deliver us. God is able to deliver every one of us in the name of Jesus. In the book of Zechariah 3 verse 4, the Bible says, "And he answered and speak unto those that stood before him, saying, take away the filthy garments from him. And unto him he said, behold, I have caused thee iniquity to pass from thee, and I will clothe thee with change of clothing." So the Lord himself, he said, he helped Joshua. The Lord is going to help you. The Lord Almighty is going to deliver you. He's going to remove that slavery and backward garment. Verse 3, Zechariah 3, verse 4, the Bible says, "And he answered and speak unto those that stood before him, saying, take away that filled garments from him." The Lord is going to take away that garment from you. The garment of slavery, the garment of backwardness, the Lord Almighty is going to remove that garment in the name of Jesus. The Lord is going to remove that garment of filthy garment in the name of Jesus. When we look at the book of Isaiah 64 verse 6, the Bible says, "We have all become like one who is unclean, and all our righteous deeds are like polluted garment. We all fade like a leaf, and our iniquities like the wind take us away." Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. The Bible says, "We have all become like one who is unclean, and all our righteous deeds are like a polluted garment. We all fade like a leaf, and out our iniquity like the wind take us away." Hallelujah. The Bible says in Isaiah 64 verse 6, we have all become like one who is unclean, and all our righteous deeds are like a polluted garment. We all fade like a leaf, and our iniquities like the wind take us away. So the Lord Almighty, he is full of mercy. He forgive us. He cleans us. Although we were polluted, although we have polluted garment, but Jesus Christ has come to take away the garment. Therefore, if the enemy does not find any sin, any disobedience, any rebellion against the words of the Lord, in one word, any legal ground to stand on garment of hindrance cannot stay on. So when your garment is polluted, when you have filled garment, then the enemy will have access, will have illegal rights to come to you. But when the enemy does not find any sin, when filled garment, it is sin. Filled garment, polluted garment is being polluted, being defiled. So now, when the enemy look at you, he doesn't see anything. He doesn't see any filled garment. He can't stay. If the enemy does not find any sin, you can have filled garment, polluted garment. That garment, if you are disobedient, if you are rebellious, if you have anger, that is filled garment. Then the devil will stay. But if he comes and see your garment is washed with salvation, hallelujah, praise the name of Jesus, he cannot stay. If therefore the enemy does not find any sin, any disobedience, any rebellion against the works of the Lord, in one word, any legal ground to stand on, garment of hindrance cannot stay on. He cannot stay because the garment of hindrance has been removed away. God himself had to intervene by rebuking Satan. Then he spoke to the angel of the Lord, delivered the message sent him by God after the change of garment. Every sin not confessed will defile garment. Every sin not confessed will defile the garment. Every sin not confessed will defile the garment. A divided garment will attract demon that will supervise contrary things in the life of a sinner. Every sin not confessed will divide a garment. A divided garment will attract demon that will supervise contrary things in the life of a sinner. The angel will not complete his assignment because Satan was present to enforce a law which Joshua the high priest has broken. Joshua the high priest had on him a filled garment, a defiled garment, a garment of sin. The angel of the Lord was just standing there, a garment of sin. He could not accomplish the task assigned unto him by God, and he could not return back to God with the message, as Joshua the high priest did not stop praying after the order of Daniel. Satan is legalized. If given the chance, he will stand his ground. The devil, Satan, he always look at the garment you are wearing. What kind of garment are you wearing? Are you wearing the garment of salvation? If you are wearing the garment of salvation, then the devil has no illegal right to come to you. Now you see the high priest Joshua. He was wearing the garment of filth, the garment of polluted, the garment of sin. Now he was standing, before the angel, before God. But the Satan looked at him and said, Joshua, the high priest, he's a sinner. He is sinning. He has done something wrong. So he has a filled garment. And the Lord has to help him and say, remove that garment from him. That's why the devil was not able to touch him. Jesus is already to deliver you from the yoke of garment of hindrance, as he delivered Joshua, the high priest, in the time of the prophet Zechariah. He is very compassionate. If only you can turn to him, you can turn to him. Jesus, he will deliver you, no matter what garment you are wearing. The Bible says, Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Hebrews 13, verse 8. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. The way he delivered Joshua, and he can deliver you. You've been working so hard. This is what I say every time. But you are wearing the garment of slavery and backwardness. But today the Lord is going to remove that slavery garment. The Lord is going to take away that slavery garment. The slavery garment. You are no longer working slavery. You are no longer going to work backwardness. You will be moving forward. You are the head. You are not the tail. You will never follow. You will lender in the name of Jesus. We are going to deal with those garments. I pray that God will deliver you and put you a new garment, put you a new clothing, put you a garment of salvation, put you a garment of prosperity, put you a garment of deliverance in the name of Jesus. All those garments of sickness in your body, the Lord is going to remove you and put you a garment of healing and put a garment of that will shine in the name of Jesus. The garment of slavery is going to be burned to ashes. The garment of backwardness is going to be removed in Jesus' name. You need the garment of prosperity in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray that God will deliver you this morning. I pray that God Almighty, by the power that he created heaven and earth, will fall upon you and will change away every satanic garment, every witchcraft garment, every polluted garment in the name of Jesus. I pray that you ask God, bring genuine repentance and confess your sins before the Lord. Just ask God to forgive you and confess your sins before God. Because God, he doesn't go with sins. And if you are sin, then that garment of sin will be removed in Jesus' name. Let's pray and ask God to take away the sins. Repent, genuinely repent in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Bring genuine repentance and the confession of your sins before the Lord. Breathe the blood of Jesus upon every confessing sin. I breathe the blood of Jesus over my sins. I ask Jesus to forgive me. I ask God Almighty to forgive me. Rebuke in the name of Jesus. Rebuke in the name of Jesus demons operating against your life because of the confession of sins. Rebuke every demon operating against your life because of the confession, because you confess the sins. When you rebuke this, they will get away from your life in Jesus' name. Lord Jesus, I thank you for the redemption power in your blood. They will redeem my life today in Jesus' name. You pray that God will redeem you from by the blood of Jesus in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord. Lord Jesus, I thank you for the garment of salvation you made valuable for those people who call upon you in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Lord, for the garment of salvation you made valuable to us through the cross of Jesus Christ. Lord, I thank you, Father. We thank you that we pray that the garment, our Lord, Lord Jesus, thank you for the garment of salvation you made valuable to us through the cross of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus, you need the garment of Jesus. You need this garment. Father God, have mercy upon us today, as you had upon Joshua, the high priest, and remove all garment of hindrance that are upon us in the name of Jesus. I pray that God will remove all the garment, all the hindrance garment upon you in the name of Jesus. I pray that God Almighty, Jesus Christ, that the way he removed that garment, he can remove also the garment in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, thank you, Father. God, Father God, have mercy upon your people. Have mercy upon these people, God, my Father. Have mercy upon your people, God, my Father. As you had a mercy upon Joshua, that the high priest, and you remove all garment of hindrance that was upon him in the name of Jesus Christ. The garment of shame, the garment of hindrance, the garment of sickness, the garment of poverty, I cast them out of your life in Jesus' name. I cast that garment of poverty. I cast that garment of sickness. I cast that garment of shame by the power and the blood of Jesus. I cast the garment of slavery. Every garment that is making you to go backward, I cast them in the name of Jesus. Jesus Christ is the same today and forever. Hebrews 13, verse 8, in the name of Jesus. Blood of Jesus, fight every battle for these people today. Every war, anything that the enemy is using, Lord Jesus, fight them in the name of Jesus. Yes, thank you, treasure. Every power putting contrary garment on you, be paralyzed. Every power putting contrary garment, the garment that does not belong to God, let that garment be paralyzed. Let that garment catch fire in the name of Jesus. Satanic garment, you know, they can put you garment. As I said, you may be walking with your suit, with your clothing, but in the spiritual realm, you are wearing satanic garment. So nothing can work for you anywhere you go. If you are wearing satanic garment, satanic of slavery, that's why people, they can hire you. They know you have a degree. They know you are educated, but they undermine you. They don't care. They don't even see you are educated. They will start mocking you. They will make fun of you. Even if they give you a job, still they are following you. They don't trust you because they see that in the spiritual realm, you are wearing filled garment, garment of disgrace. You can wear a garment of disgrace, garment of shame. Anywhere you go, people, they don't recognize you. Or they reject you. Or they don't recognize you. They don't want to hear your voice. Even you can wear a garment that whenever you talk, people, they just see like garbage. They don't hear anything you are saying. That is the garment of filthy garment, all of polluted garment. Anything you do, nobody will recognize. Nobody will say, yeah, thank you. No, you will never, you work a place 10 years, you know, appreciation is very good. Even if you are possible to say thank you, you are good. But you never get anything showing you have been working good, anything, thank you. They don't want to see, to say anything. Other people comes, they are in front line. I know there was a lady where I was working. She just come within 2 months. The woman was signing, was everywhere. She was like a star. Everybody, she got all the gifts from the people and everybody. So we said something is not right here. And there's some people who are working better than this woman. And they have been there for many years, but they never get even a card, even anything, even saying thank you. But this woman, because she came with whatever she came with, and now she was signing, but few months after 3 months, because what she was using, and she met a person of God, a woman of God came in that company. And this woman has recognized that this girl is not normal. It's not normal. This is not normal. So he rebuked that garment she was wearing. And the garment raped her. And the woman was calmed down. And things started working. And God started using that manager. And the people were calm and were friendly than before. So when Satan can put you a garment that will disgrace you or bring you down, you see, Satan can also make you to sign for a few days to put you up there, and they reduce you down to zero. You have seen people with the wealthy, and tomorrow you found them, they are nothing. They don't have even sandals to wear in their feet. That's what the work of the wicked. We pray that God Almighty have mercy upon you, have mercy upon us in the name of Jesus. That's why you need to pray the blood of Jesus, fight for my battle, fight for me in the name of Jesus, and burn to ashes every satanic garment in Jesus' name. Every power putting contrary garment on you, be paralyzed in Jesus' name. Every evil garment that has put you in the wilderness of life, lost in the name of Jesus. There is evil garment that will put you in the wilderness where you wander many places in the dry desert. Nothing is you don't see anything. Everything is blockage. Everything, it is not working for you. So much stuff. Everything, you don't know where to stand. That is the wilderness. That is wilderness. Where you have nowhere to turn to. But the Lord Jesus is the same today and forever. He will deliver you. Wherever the garment the enemy has put to you, the Lord Almighty is going to burn them to ashes. They want to be roasted in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus, garment of the enemy that is battering your destiny, I command them to tear down in the name of Jesus. They are garment of the devil that is battering your destiny. Wherever your destiny is signing, they are there, they block it, they cover it. In the name of Jesus, I command them to tear down to pieces in Jesus' name. Territory spirit putting on you garment of slavery, I command them to be paralyzed in the name of Jesus. Territory spirit putting on you garment of slavery, be paralyzed in the name of Jesus. Territorial spirit are the spirit that works when you go to another country or another city. They follow you and put you a garment. You remain the same, no different from where you from your country. And you come here, you suffer more, you become more slavery than your country. If you look at it, I was watching the CNN yesterday, and I saw black people and white people. Yeah, now this young man who killed the police, he said that he wants to kill the white police, and the white people also. One of them was saying that he has been abused, he has been bullying by the white person. You see, that is the garment of garment of shame and the garment of filth. When it reaches like that, people, they started fighting themselves. Somebody who came from another country to come and live good life, now you change, you start killing people for no reason. Your forefathers came to better your life. America is a good country. Canada is a country. Even in Africa, when you go to another country, there, you have to You have to see that this is opportunity God has brought you here. And you have to ask the garment of salvation. Now the territorial garment are waiting for you to put you that garment of territory. So nothing will work for you. That's what is happening. You forgot that this country, the very country where you are abusing, where you are doing this, God has not brought you there. You came to that country for better your life. Otherwise, you could stay in your country. Now here there is a division. That is territorial spirit. The territorial spirit has brought the division among the people. And people who are living in darkness, they can't realize this. They started fighting themselves. We pray that God Almighty to burn to ashes every territorial spirit garment in your life in Jesus' name. We live like one people. Where you see divisions, you see now the territorial spirit, they go to churches and they say, let us have different churches. Let us have white churches. Let us have white church. Let us have black people church. Let us have African church. Let us have Nigerian church. Let us have Kenyan church. Let us have Ghanaian church. That is territorial filled garment. Because Jesus Christ did not die for Ghanaian, did not die for Nigeria, did not die for white people, did not die for black people. Jesus Christ died for all of us. When you see that division, that is territorial demons. So you have to refuse it. If you say you are a Ghanaian church, you don't understand English, you want to go there because of the language, that is a lie. In a hospital, you go to hospital, everybody's going there. You go to the workplace, I've not seen this work is for Ghanaian, this work is for Nigerians, this work for African. All the work I see, everybody's working. Now here, when it comes to churches, it comes to praise and worship, it comes to things of God, you have division. Why? Territorial demons, they have put garment, they have put the pastors, the priest, the pope, the bishops, they are wearing filled garment. Now, when they wear this filled garment, no matter, they will bring division. They look opposite. They start bringing racism. The churches must stand against this division. Churches, they have to wear the garment of salvation. They have to unite the people together. Because now the devil is indeed putting this garment of filth to people, to even churches. Everyone is very bitter and is very happy. This demon of territorial demons, spirit, territorial spirit, putting on the garment to become a slave, to bring divisions. Any territorial spirit assigned to put you on the garment of slavery and backwardness, I command them to be paralyzed in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus, you have to command that territorial spirit assigned to put you the garment of slavery and backwardness. And you command them to be paralyzed. You have to take time to pray. If I'm wearing a garment of slave, I command that garment to catch fire. One day, God opened my eyes and I saw some people. The way they walk, you see them, they are walking with underwear. They are carrying underwear. And they are walking, they think they are carrying a bag, handbag. But the handbag they are putting on their shoulder is the underwear. And everything is sewing. That is a garment of filth. You think that. You pray that every garment of slavery and backward, I command you to catch fire. Yes, thank you, treasure, you got it. I command every territorial garment, a garment, in the name of Jesus, any territorial spirit assigned to put you on the garments of slavery and backwardness, be paralyzed in the name of Jesus. Let them catch fire and burn to ashes in Jesus' name. Garment of slavery and backwards on your life, I command them to be consumed by fire. Be consumed by fire in Jesus' name. Pray like this. Garment of slavery and backwardness on me, be consumed by fire of God. You have to pray and confess. You say, any territorial spirit assigned to put on me the garment of slavery and backward, be paralyzed in the name of Jesus. You pray like this. Garment of slavery and the backwardness on me, be consumed in the name of Jesus. This is a very serious prayer. You need to pray and ask God if there is any garment. If you are not aware of the garment you are wearing, you pray these prayers, those garments will catch fire and you will be free in Jesus' name. It will be removed by the power and the blood of Jesus. Any territorial spirit assigned to put on me the garments of slavery and backwardness, be paralyzed in the name of Jesus. Be paralyzed in Jesus' name. Pray like that. Thank you, Tracer. Any territorial spirits assigned to put on me the garment of slavery and backwardness, be paralyzed in Jesus' name. I like Dave. Dave, pray very hard. Speak loud, Dave, my son. Garment of slavery, I hear you. I hear you in my head. Garment of slavery and backwardness on me, be consumed in the name of Jesus. Garment of slavery, garments of slavery and backwardness on me, be consumed in the name of Jesus. I come against the power of the Queen of Heaven, imposing the garment of slavery and backwardness on me by the blood of Jesus. I come against the power of the Queen of the Heaven, imposing the garments of slavery and backwardness on me by the blood of Jesus. Come against that Queen of Heavens, imposing the garment of slavery and backwardness on you. Be paralyzed, be turned to ashes in Jesus' name. Pray like this. I come against the power of the Queen of the Heaven. I come against the power of the Queen of the Heaven, imposing the garment of slavery and backwardness on me by the blood of Jesus. By the blood of Jesus, come against the Queen of Heaven, imposing the garment of slavery and backwardness in the name of Jesus Christ. Pray like this. Garment of the enemy, barbering my destiny, I tear you down to pieces in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord, thank you, Jesus. My God, I want to bless your name. Yes, oh Lord. Every garment of destruction upon my life, lost by fire. Every garment of destruction upon my life, lost by fire in the name of Jesus. Treasure, you are writing very well. Thank you so much. Every garment of destruction upon my life, roast by fire. Every garment of destruction, let it be roasted in the name of Jesus. I roast you in Jesus' name. Every garment of destruction upon my life, roast, be roasted, be roasted, be roasted by fire in the name of Jesus. Garment of death on me, roast by fire. There are a garment of death. Some of you, some people that are wearing garment of death. Roast, 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 R-O-S, R-O-A-S-T. Roast in the name of Jesus. Like roasting meat. Yes, thank you, Jesus. Every garment of destruction upon my life, roast by fire. Roast by fire. R-O-A-S-T. Yes, correct. Thank you. That is roast. Be roasted. Be roasted in the name of Jesus. If they get roast, if you roast the meat, you roast tea, you roast meat, you roast chicken, let them be roasted. Let those garments catch fire and burn to ashes. Let them be roasted like chicken in the name of Jesus. Yes, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Garment of death on you, I command them to be roasted by fire in Jesus' name. Thank you, Ego. Thank you for coming. Garment of infirmity in me. Garment infirmity on me. Burn to ashes in Jesus' name. The garment of infirmity. That's why you see people, they have sickness. They have cancer. They have sickness in their body that does not respond from any medication. That is a garment of infirmity. People have so much infirmities. They have some sickness that does not want to go. So this garment, I command them to catch fire. You command a garment of infirmity on me, burn to ashes. If the devil has put a garment of infirmity, no medicine can respond it. So that's why you command them to catch fire. If you burn them to ashes, that sickness will go. Jesus Christ, remember, is the same today and forever. It doesn't change. She's the one who delivered Joshua when Joshua was found with the garment of filth. So the same Jesus is one to burn out that garment of sickness and diseases in the name of Jesus Christ. It is a garment. Hallelujah. Garment of failure at the gate of success in me, burn to ashes in Jesus' name. This garment of failure, no matter how hard you work, no matter what you do, there was a man, the doctor, here in Canada. He tried to pass the test. He was not able to pass the test because the garment of failure has put the garment of failure in him. The man has a degree. He's only to pass examination to study practice as a doctor in this country. There's a test you have to pass. This one you can practice as a doctor. He has done everything, but to get that certificate was very hard for him to pass. Not that he was stupid, not that he was a fool. It is because garment of failure has put in his life, and he didn't know. So when I went there, when I prayed for him, that garment of failure fall down and catch fire. The man went straight away and they passed his test. When you have the garment of infirmity, no matter, unless the pastor, unless the priest, or they know which garment is in your body. So the garment of infirmity, if you set them fire, all the sickness will be melt in Jesus' name. The garment of poverty, when you set it fire, it will burn to ashes. That's why that I'm going to pray for you, that the Lord Almighty will remove every garment of shame, slavery, the backwardness in Jesus' name. My sister, Tagwa, the Lord Almighty is going to remove every garment of sickness, diseases, every garment of shame is going to remove in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus, everyone who has been attacked by the garment of disgrace, by the garment of sickness, by the garment of diseases and infirmity, it is going to burn to ashes in Jesus' name. Garment of loneliness on me, I tear you to pieces in Jesus' name. There is garment of loneliness. People they feel so lonely. They have no friends. They are isolated. That is a garment. Nobody loves you. Nobody. You don't have company. You are by yourself. That is a garment of loneliness. Therefore, I burn that garment to ashes in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus, garment of loneliness, I burn you to ashes in Jesus' name. Garment of poverty on me, be consumed in the name of Jesus. Garment of poverty on me, be consumed by fire in the name of Jesus. Let's consume the garment of poverty in the name of Jesus. Yes, garment of loneliness, burn to ashes in Jesus' name. That is very good prayer. We pray that you cannot wear a garment of loneliness. At that garment, I burn them to ashes in Jesus' name. I pray that garment of rejection on me, I tear you to pieces in Jesus' name. There is garment of rejection. You are being rejected everywhere you go. People, they reject you. Nobody respects you. When they see you, even if you are driving, even if you have what, you are rejected. The whole family can reject you. Your own husband reject you. Your own children, they reject you. Your own family, brothers and sisters from same mother, same father, they reject you. Everywhere you are rejected because of this garment of rejection. Therefore, I pray and I burn them to ashes. I tear it to pieces in Jesus' name. Every garment of rejection in your life, anybody that has gone this garment of rejection, I set them fire. It is very, very painful when you have the garment of rejection. It will start and then it will go on everywhere. So that's why people feel like they have no life. They have to end their life. They have nowhere to turn to. By the power and the blood of Jesus, I burn that garment. I tear it to pieces in Jesus' name. My God, I want to thank you, God. I want to worship you and honor you, Jesus. Thank you, Father God. Jesus, you are the same today and forever. You never change, God. Help us, Lord. Tear down every satanic garment. Tear it down and burn it to ashes in Jesus' name. Every garment of shame, slavery, backwardness, I set you fire in the name of Jesus. All these garments that people are wearing and they are not aware, today, I command them to catch fire and burn to ashes in Jesus' name. I pray that God will deliver you. You will be set free in Jesus' name. You have been crying so much. No more tears will come from your eyes. Let those garments burn to ashes. And I pray that God will put you a garment of salvation, garment of joy, garment of peace, garment of prosperity in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. My God, I want to thank you and bless your name and give you all the glory. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Thank you that today, every satanic garment, every witchcraft garment has been burned to ashes in Jesus' name. Receive the garment of salvation. Receive the garment of prosperity. Receive the garment of power in the name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus, I thank God. I bless God that God is able to deliver you from the hands of the enemy. That those garments has been burned to ashes in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. I want to thank God for everyone that have come. You can have this video. You can have this prayer. You need to speak against these garments. They are wicked, evil, satanic garment, polluted garment, filthy garment. And you have no idea the garment you are wearing. You have to pray this prayer so that this garment will be destroyed in Jesus' name. I am going to upload these videos. It is going to be our website, our YouTube, and everywhere in the media. Please share these videos. Paste on your page and share it to your friends. It will help your people. It is going to help friends. Don't be mean. Just share these videos. Share with the other friends in the name of Jesus. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Yes, I will send you. I will send you clothes. You need this. You need to confess and pray. I'm going to send everyone who needs them. If you request me, if you don't request me, I can't send you. Yes, I pray that God will deliver you in Jesus' name. Our website is www.overcomersdhm.ca. Our website is www.overcomersdhm.ca. All, if you don't understand what I'm saying or you don't hear exactly what I'm saying, let me give you the number to call me. Use a card if you are long distance. You have to spend some money. You don't need everything free. There's nothing free. You have to get your card and call me. This is the number if you need a prayer. If you can't, some people, they don't know. I talk with the people in America and Canada. They have no idea. They don't know how to go to the website. They have no idea about that. But the number, they can reach me, and I'm happy for them. So, and even some of them, they don't know text message. So we thank God for them. The number you can reach me, text message or a cell phone anywhere in the world. You can reach me this number, 647-608-5207. 647-608-5207. You can call me, you can go to WhatsApp. Skype. You can reach me. You can go to our line, direct line, landline, 905-487-7196. This number, it's for you. You can call me. Don't expect that you need everything free. You have to spend some money. You have to call a card and come to prayer conference. We pray, and I'm going to prophesy on the prayer conference, not Periscope. I will have a day only to speak, to minister to you individual. I'm looking that day. So everybody will come to a prayer conference. Then I can spend some hours to minister every one of you and prophesy to you and speak the word, live word to your spirit in the name of Jesus. Thank you very much. God bless you so much. And remember also our email address is overcomersdhm@gmail.com or Google, write Christine Isigi, then everything will come up. If you don't know how to get us, go and write Christine Sig or Prophetess Dr. Christine Sig. Everything will come. On the page of our Periscope, you see my name is there. Write that name in a website. You will find it in the internet. It will come up. Thank you very much. I want to know that lady called Lynn Bull. Lynn Bull, I don't know you, and I thank you so much for your donation. I've never spoke to you, but I thank you. I love you so much for just the Holy Spirit read you and you donate, because you have been blessed in this ministry. If you have been blessed with this ministry, go to our website and donate an amount. Donate an amount and God will bless you. If you are really facing financial difficulty, if you are having financial difficulty, call me. I will ask the Father to release finances breakthrough to your life. Call me. If you are being affected with your finances, call me. I will speak to the Father. And the Father will release that money where it has been held. And obey. Obedience is better than sacrifice. When you obey the voice of the prophet, you will prosper. If you don't obey the voice of the prophet, no matter, it cannot prosper. So you have to learn how to be obedient in Jesus' name. Thank you very much. See you tomorrow, 8 o'clock. We don't have night. We don't have midnight prayer. Don't call midnight prayer, please. We don't have midnight prayer tonight. We have tomorrow, 8 o'clock. Tomorrow, 8 o'clock, invite people, come to prayer line. And if you need prayers, call me. Call me, I will pray with you. Thank you very much. God bless you. And have a wonderful time. I love you so much. There is nothing I can do about it. Amen. I love you. I love you. I love you. Amen.